Welcome, and Japan Track. And now preparing the next speakers on the EOFFA session.
Honto, kore? Maji?
Sakune, kore? Kore na mae, konna janakatta ne.
Maji.
だって片方クーバニーティスねえだよ日本語で言うけど
いや本気で今日本語分かる人だけに日本語のトークすると本当に僕はクーバニーティスねえの向こうに行って本当にどっかのセキュリティについて勝ち込み行こうかと本気で思ってましたから人来なさすぎるからこっちでクーバニーティスの話をしようかなと思ったぐらいなんで勝ち込みってすみません中国のいくらでも日本分かりきりですね乗り込んでとにかく俺に喋らせろっていう話をしようかなとクーバネティスのセキュリティについてだけど今日はここのトラックの担当をしなきゃいけないので頑張ります
すごくないです
かね先生準備終わりました
OK
よしじゃあ Please have a seat Please have a seat If you are sorryあ、ちょっと待ってくださいね。なんか椅子が足んねえとか。なんでそんな現象まで起きるんだ皆さん。コロナ前は大変だったんですよ人来なくて。マジで。こんな変な DJ トークみたいなのやってますけど、本当コロナ前人来なかったの。マジで大変だったのに。まあ、今回はまあいいスピーカー揃えましたからね、それは自慢なんですけど、日本語で言ってるけど、はい、I'm proud to say that giving a good speaker in Japan, so I'm very much appreciate on their tone people, who has? マジかよ、
すごいね、
これ多すぎる、こんな予想はしなかったから、はい、next speaker is Iyo 先生。Iyo sensei is working for Tutor University and you know one of the major Japanese university. He's been teaching on the computer science. He's talking about the programming lessons. So please welcome Iyo sensei. よろしくお願いします。Iyo sensei、よろしくお願いします。間違えた。
Okay, it's no problem. Okay, hello everyone. I'm very happy to be here, and I was a little bit surprised so to facing so many audiences. So I'm very happy from over three years pandemic, I could come back here. So my name is Jun Iyo from Chu University, and today I'd like to talk about source code is a good tutor to learn programming, accessibility assessment in several cases of programming lessons. Okay, let me start with my self-introduction.As I mentioned previously, my name is Jun Iyo, not Ito. some Japanese people make a mistake by calling me as Ito, because Ito is a very famous surname in Japan. But my name is Iyo, and some Western people call me Rio, not Iyo. And I know that the pronunciation of Iyo is slightly difficult for foreign people, so please call me Jun. Call me Jun, please. Okay, I am a professor of the university, Chu University, and also I am a board member of OSS Association Japan, and my major is human-computer interaction. So today I'm talking about the engineer education of the computer science. So does anyone? Let's start the question. Are there any person who are in charge of education? If you are okay. So today's my talk will be some hint for you. Reading well-structured source code is an effective way to learn programming skills. The free, libre, and open source software is considered an excellent tutor to learning guide for programming learning courses. But in actual programming classes, it's not apparent that the teacher considers the source code of real application as good examples. When I was young, I'm 53 years old, very old man. But when I was young and at that time I'm a novice programmer, I read the source code of GTK, you know, GTK, widget set for GNOME environment. Though it became highly complicated now, but at that time it was relatively simple, and it didn't require any burden to read the code. It taught me how to build code in object-oriented design using C language, not C++. You can make some program in using non OOP programming language. As you know, C language is not OOP, but you can design some programming in object oriented style with using just C. GTK was built built in such a way, so it was my pleasure to know that. That was the first time to read well structured code and understood the importance of reading better code. Okay, this is the very famous book published in 1977, Lyon's Commentary, Commentary on the Unix Operating System Version 6 by John Lyons. The book explained the source code of ATT's Unix 6 edition. It's also a suitable textbook for learning how to write good code. It's now available online in the Internet Archive, which means you can read it by accessing the page. It's a kind of treasure of the internet, I believe. This is the research question. My question is, how many teachers think well-structured code could be an excellent tutor to learn to programming a program? Are there? So I did several interviews with my colleagues about the issues. In this talk, I report the case studies from some professors. The ITL is my faculty's nickname. This is the a short brief introduction of my faculty. the Agile faculty is stepping forward to embrace the demand of the AI and IoT era. Although the faculty focuses on basic knowledge of IT, information technology, and the ability to manage information with law, that is the reason why our faculty's nickname is ITL. IT stands for Information Technology and Law. It's an arts and social science faculty that, though global liberal arts, it keeps individuals with unique problem-solving skill based on synergistic knowledge and academic fields. This is the world of my the dean of our faculty. Firstly, I'd like to introduce my case. I am in charge of teaching the subject basic programming course. It's the mandatory course for the first grade student. My faculty is relatively very small faculty, and the number of students is 150, only 150. And we have 8 teachers teaching basic programming course for 150 students. So that result in from 15 to 12 students in one class. This subject covers the basic idea of programming using C language. That means we are using GCC, GDB, and other tools in Ubuntu Linux environment. And I, at the end of the class, end of the term period, I assigned my students to make your own program, or some students say I cannot make my original program, so I asked them modify sample program. I provided three sample programs, Sokoban game. Does anyone know the Sokoban? No? No one? Ah, yeah. Sokoban is a very old-fashioned games. It was very popular in Japan for 30 years ago. The program was made by Mr. Harada. He is one of my colleagues, and hit and home run game made by me. You can retrieve the source code from the URL. I put my source code placed into the GitHub, and Eight Queens is some puzzles to solving. So I gave the program to solve the eight queen problem. This is the screenshot of the Sokoban game. You can control the penguin to correct the keys. And pushing these boxes, but you can put the box, but cannot pull the box. After you collect all keys, you can exit from. Next slide shows the screenshot of hit and home run game. Hit and home run game is okay. I will make a demonstration of the hit and home run game. First, cloning the source code from GitHub. And and make it and run a program HHR. So welcome to the hit and homer game. You have to guess the four digit numbers, and every time you enter number, the software will give some clues, hit and home run. So the first try I put a four digit number like 1, 2, 3, 4, and software says two hits and one home run. So one, I assumed one is home run. So I 3, 4, 8, like this. This one is not a home run. So, okay. Hit and home run is hit and home run game is just like the operated like this. So please play by yourself after this session. Okay, let's go back to the presentation. the third one is solving eight queen puzzles. Does anyone know eight queens? Some people know. Eight queen is a kind of puzzles to place eight queens in one chessboard. Not to make any collisions. That means there are 92 patterns to solve this program. The eight queen solver provide all of the answers to eight queen puzzles. Code size of these sample programs is like here. Hit and home run, the source code of hit and home run game is slightly complicated other than other two programs. This is my case. I conducted interviews with my colleagues who teach programming and other subjects in information engineering in the faculty of Global Informatics at Tutor University. Question is following: do you have any classes that explain source code, such as reading source code, or do you have any classes in which source code is shared and worked on? Do you handle existing source code such as OSS in your classes? After all, please tell me your thoughts of using actual source code as teaching materials. I conducted the interview to four of my colleagues, Professor Tokuyasu Kakuta, Associate Professor Masaki Kohana, Associate Professor Kazutaka Matsuzaki, and Associate Professor Masahiko Yoshida. Next, I'd like to introduce Professor Matsuzaki's case. In his basic programming class, he uses the sysprog example code set. This is also very famous for teaching programming, and you can you can get all materials from GitHub from this URL. This code set contains an example of the code set, and this repository contains a collection of simple C programs that demonstrate different aspects of programming on Linux. They were originally developed by Scott Kuhl to complement CS3411 system programming at Michigan Technology University. This is the screenshot of the SysProg example. They have many many source code examples in the simple example folder. He also uses well-structured code set in his teaching activities. He and his students are reading the book titled Practical Time Series Analysis. The book also provides code examples in as open source software. Everyone can get it from GitHub, from this URL, github.com practical time series analysis book repo. You can get all of the code example explained in this book. Next, I'd like to show the Professor Kakta's case. His teaching style is very traditional. He teaches to make a web application from scratch using HTML, CSS, and CGI. Very old-fashioned style. He never used any frameworks. It's very old-fashioned style. In that sense, copying a code fragment of HTML and CSS from an excellent web page is considered using well-structured open source software, because HTML and CSS can be acquired freely, just like open source software. Recently, his student often used ChatGPT to learn how to use open source software library. It doesn't mean using open source source as a good code example, because they use it only through the APIs provided by the OSS library, instead of reading open source software source code. Professor Kohana and Yoshida's case, they have never introduced code reading to their teaching activities. It's very sad case. Oops. They want to introduce code reading into their teaching activities, but they are worried about student skill level. It's very unfortunate case. Reading kernel code in the subject of explaining the operating system is very they consider it's very important, but they worried about student skill. That means, unfortunately, our student is not good to unfortunately, our students don't have such high level skills, so they are worried about the student skill levels. it would be suitable for graduate students instead of undergraduate students. Final issue is using GitHub. All professors mentioned the use of GitHub. The GitHub could help share codes developed by students, but however, the GitHub system is complicated enough, they said. It needs to be simplified to enable average students to utilize it. Some professors said that Subversion was better than GitHub. It's very simple enough. Okay, let me conclude my talk. Reading well-structured code is good practice for learning programming, but it requires a skill level to some extent. So our professor pointed out that it's questionable to introduce undergraduate education. On the other hand, it could be helpful for teaching programming at a higher level, such as graduate education. In addition, a simple code sharing tool instead of GitHub is expected at the undergraduate level of education. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much, 先生. Any other question about his talk? No? ないかな? Question? Yeah.
So based on your conclusion, you're talking about the importance of code quality and well-structured code. And it's important that the student in college or grad school learn to write well-structured code, right?
Mm-hmm.
In your perspective as an educator, mm-hmm. it's important for a student to read well-organized code and then
learn how
to write well-structured code.
Yes.
Yeah, and what do you think is the difficulties for, I don't know in Japan, but in Taiwan, it's like most of the time, fresh grad don't really know how to write well-structured code.
Yeah. I think it's easy to read a simple code for our students, but in the real open source software code is very complicated enough, and it requires to some burden for students, for example, very long time focusing on the reading very large code, something like that. So that result in, of course, in our students, some students who has strong passion or some. Who'd like to study hard, they can learn from some such complicated code. But average students, I don't think it's good to reading is very difficult for them. So so it's not suitable for the average student. But graduate, if average undergraduate student, that is our conclusion.
Yeah, if you engage in the educational program in Taiwan, mm-hmm. then how will you propose somehow a system, not just individual effort or enthusiasm, or passion, mm-hmm. some sort of any proposal that can improve their ability to trace code, to read code, and as well as produce well-structured code. Like, what's your perspective?
it's very difficult question. そうですね。いや、日本語でもちょっと難しいです。はい。I imagine one method is step by step education. In practically, I don't have any practical idea right now, but step by step education can be used to promote such to foster the average foster the level skill level of average students. I believe.
thank you.
Any other question? No? No? Okay. So, thank you very much, Iyo Sensei. And I much appreciated your talk. Thank you very much. Next speaker is me. Raspberry Pi and business and if and supposed and so on the subject. ね、ビジネスの話やしてもあまり面白くないからと思って今日はあれなんだけど、そうなんだよね、若い人たちがあれだから。はい、We had a 10 minutes break and then and I will talk on the Raspberry Pi whole business but any stocksAnd if it's not fun to us or the business enterprise person, I will give a talk and in a BYU style to discuss with you.